Hey, what's up, everyone? Neo Scyther here, getting back to my WWE 2K16 career. And if my math is right, this should be the last month where I will be holding the Intercontinental Championship. I should be bypassing the Honky Tonk Man's record at the end of the month. I can finally move on to the World Heavyweight Championship. And I will, pardon my French, I know I don't swear much on this channel, but I will be damned if my last rival is Tyson Kidd again. So, one way or the other, I'm probably going to be walking out of Raw with a rival. I don't know who, but I'm going to be walking out of Raw with a rival. So, barring that, we have a one-on-one with Goldust. Authority goal of putting on a 4-star match or better. Well, let's go ahead and do this. Monday Night Raw.
There's no other way to put it. This one-on-one match.
Don't look now, but we got company.
Really? Seth Rollins.
No one's backing down here. What an impasse.
Man, so Seth Rollins is now at ringside. I wasn't even paying attention to that.
No one wants to give an inch.
What do you have on Goldust?
The sky's the limit. I see a lot of main events in the future.
Yeah, and that's it.
Wearing down the opposition here.
Oh, out here you have to be able to think on your feet lightning fast.
When I figure Rollins out here because we are close to SummerSlam.
And you could find yourself in a world of hurt.
Two.
Yeah, I figured that was kind of a stupid idea, but.
Good Lord, that wasn't even close.
So that's what it's like being so far off the mark.
Two.
Oh, out of nowhere.
Okay, fair enough.
Back in the ring again.
Good. Keep it in the ring, guys.
I'm going to kind of ignore Rollins because the last time someone was out of ringside for one of my matches and I did something to him, he then came back at me and got disqualified or got my opponent disqualified. Long story short, I lost quite a few skill points because of that.
In 1995, Goldust has achieved fame, notoriety, and infamy all at once. He's been an Intercontinental Champion. He had the famous backlot brawl at WrestleMania 12 against Rowdy Roddy Piper, and he's held tag team gold and was a hardcore
champion. I don't want to lose my freaking reversal I'm building up.
Look out. Bam!
Tremendous.
Goldust is taking it to me in this match.
Oh, man.
What submission is this?
To the brain. You could pass out from a hold like that.
Textbook offense here.
Oh, I remember being in WWE when Goldust debuted. And it's safe to say
that
no
means to target Rollins.
Goldust was definitely
that's wrong because I got. I have clicking the left stick set to targeting someone. It doesn't take much to accidentally press this thing down.
And his heartless attack continues.
Oh, man. This is getting tough to watch. Why has he got his opponent, and what's he going for here?
Make no mistake about it. This is getting ugly.
Yeah, now we're just talking about his face.
Wait. Is he still conscious?
Man, that looked bad.
Oh, that went poorly.
Nicely executed. If I had to suggest a strategy.
Crap, I was expecting that to be a rest hold, not a submission.
Goldust's unusual demeanor takes opponents right out of their game. An opponent will have to look past.
I'll give him credit. This is
I agree, Cole.
This is going not as good as I'd hoped.
Easier said than done. I think it's tough for anyone not to be affected by someone's antics who's known as the Bizarre One.
We're looking at complete domination here.
If he keeps
hated
up
to reverse
match,
that, but I didn't want to.
Real fast.
As an ally, he's just doing his job. He's being distracting.
Since when were they allies? I just noticed I had something pop up that I could have done, but.
Oh, what a terrific
epic reversal by Goldust.
King, we spoke earlier about a suggested strategy for an opponent of Goldust. That strategy has to be to focus.
He goes to the quick pin attempt. Count, Rev, count.
Quick pin attempt. I don't know what match you're watching. It's been going on for a while, unless you mean him putting the pin on me was quick. But
on the roster is crowded around the monitors in the back to see which one of these guys comes out victorious.
Oh, wait, nice reversal.
Ow.
Seeing Goldust move like this makes it impossible.
Well, this could be bad.
WWE debut was back.
I have no way of reversing anything he does to me now.
Swimming in the fountain of youth. The bizarre one's kicking tail.
Big move there. And he goes for the pin. There's the count.
I have no stamina to roll out. I just got a reversal.
There's nothing wrong here. He can talk as much as he wants. If the guy in the ring gets distracted by it.
And there's his finisher.
Not his.
Hey, this may very well be it.
I'm not quite dead yet.
Quick thinking to avoid that. Look at the attack here.
Jeez.
Oh, talk about a direct hit.
Okay, Goldust, we get it.
Look at this man. He's all business.
And that's the way he has to be if he wants to win here tonight. He's in big trouble.
Both of these competitors have so much resolve, it's going to take a minor miracle to keep one of them down.
Well, this game has kicked it into overdrive. Man. Goldust is putting a beating on me. I can't really blame Rollins at ringside. He's only distracted me once.
The shoulders are down.
I barely have him in the yellow. Okay, let me get out of the ring and just kind of walk around for a bit, get some of my stamina. Reversal's back, jeez.
Taking on some moderate offense here. Going to
I like that taunt. Remember that from your defense. Good old days?
Three.
These guys giving this sold-out crowd exactly what they came to see. What an incredible match. And that's why the adage holds true. There's a first time for everything.
I think
yeah, first time to get my butt kicked by Goldust on a grand scale here.
Uh-oh.
And Davidson gets all of it.
Ouch, that had to hurt.
Now, sadly, that's going to be nowhere near the finish of a match.
And he gets into the ropes.
My best bet for finishing this match might be a submission.
Showing an aggressive side here.
Or we can go for a moonsault, see what happens.
I don't know how. Oh, man, from the hot rim district.
I wouldn't know what that's. This might be it.
One, two.
And there's an extremely destructive strike.
Whoa, a direct hit. Talk about getting tagged and knocked in the middle of next week.
We're looking at complete domination here.
Look at this. This could be it.
And Davidson gets all of it.
Ouch. That had to hurt. Not a lot of spring left in his step right now.
Whoa. That's okay, Seth. He actually just kind of bought me some time. I mean, you should have done that after I hit the finisher, but maybe in his mind he thought I was going to go for the pin, which, no, I'm not.
And Davidson gets all of it.
Ouch. That had to hurt.
There's the finishing move.
Honestly, I was trying to actually dive outside the ring and hit Rollins.
Such a brutal physical battle this has been, and it's not over yet. When he gets going like this, there are a few better. Curtain call lands. Oh, looking for all the glory here.
They have to waste a reversal so I can reverse his finisher.
A wild overhead punch wreaking havoc in here.
No kidding, that shot came out of nowhere.
Time to get it back, am I?
Looks like Goldust's going to do it again. When you're beat up, the last thing you want to have to deal with is, hey, this may very well be it.
I am not going to die. So does Rollins just completely leave ringside?
These two never cease to entertain the WWE.
I think Rollins just got up and left.
Twice as nice.
Oh man, is he fired up?
He did. Rollins just up and left ringside.
I'm not sure he can get back to his feet.
I don't think I've seen that happen where the person who's out here giving me a problem just up and leaves.
Hey, somebody's having soul for dinner.
Now I meant to do.
Oh, what a suplex. This guy has strength, that's for sure.
Oh, gosh. Hey, what do you want for your last meal?
Oh, nice reversal. Actually, I have the stamina to roll out now.
Folks, if you want to learn about Raw's most tumultuous period, be sure to check out the Monday Night War on WWE Network.
Oh, everyone's down. Perfect.
Wow, he's still down after that.
Yeah, Rollins literally just gave up.
We're looking at complete domination here.
Come on, Goldust. Come and get me. That was badly timed.
You're watching Raw for more than 20 years, the premier program in all of sports entertainment.
Not this. He's looking at it again.
Again, I've not hit a Blue Thunder Bomb all match. I don't know what match you're watching. Honestly, I don't even know how I'm still in this match.
Five. Seems like these guys are letting out a lot of pent-up frustration tonight.
Six.
Not going to win many matches with that move.
Oh, out of nowhere!
This could be all she wrote. Davidson gets all of it.
Ouch, that had to hurt.
Okay, we're both kind of dead. Let's say if that didn't get the job done, I don't know what would, but holy cow, what a match. That was definitely deserving of the 5 stars between the two of us.
Here's your winner, the X-Factor, Russell Davidson.
I just like the fact that Rollins gave up on distracting me and left ringside. That was actually pretty hilarious.
It'll be interesting to see the fallout following this big singles win here tonight.
Welcome back to the show. This is my guest tonight. Let's talk about Seth Rollins.
Sure.
He ambushed you tonight during your own match. Have anything to share on that?
Didn't do a good job of it.
No one does that to me. He's in for a world of hurt. He must know who he's messing with. I'll teach him what's up. He's gonna learn that he can't go around attacking anyone. He picked the wrong guy.
There is a lot of tension brewing between you two. What's going on there?
Yeah, there is tension between us. Tension that's going to end soon with me putting him through the mat. He's in my sights, and I'm not going to quit until he's done for. I know you can hear me out there. You better run. You better not get in the ring with me, because it will be your last match.
just like the triple threat where I lost my title.
There you have it. Back to you, Cole.
I don't have a good track record with Seth Rollins right now.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring.
Uh-oh. Do you see who's coming out? I don't like the looks of this.
I don't think anyone is considering the consequences of actions like this.
There's a fine line between not thinking of consequences and just outright not caring about them.
That was good. Yeah.
That's how you do it. Make a name for yourself, kid.
Climb the ladder, kid. Make yourself famous.
And Davidson gets all of it.
Ouch, that had to hurt.
And he goes right after him.
Oh, there it is. What a maneuver. That's how you put away an opponent. I love it.
Now, this is a variation of a sharpshooter.
He's fighting back. What heart.
Ha-ha, that's how you do it. Make a name for yourself, kid.
Dolph Ziggler's night is over.
I don't think that's how Ziggler envisioned this match going.
Please welcome my guest tonight.
Again.
Let's talk about Dolph Ziggler. You two met face-to-face in the ring tonight. What was the goal of that?
He needs to know that he is not the only big dog in town. He's got some stiff competition. He needs to know that I'm the biggest roadblock to his success in the WWE. He's not taking my spot. Let's see who owns this yard. It's either me or him.
Thanks for the time. Back to you.
Apparently, there's no tension brewing between the two of us. So, even with everything that happened, that should still give me Ziggler as a rival, if the past is any indication. No, really? Okay, then. I am now in a rival with the WWE World Heavyweight Champion. So, apparently, it's whoever becomes your rival first. Because I initially wanted Ziggler to be my final rival. But, I will take Rollins. And just looking at the rankings, yep, he's still champion. And actually, that's kind of fitting when you think about it, that my last rival as Intercontinental Champion is going to be the guy I'm going to eventually go after for the World Heavyweight Championship. Anyways, we got a one. That actually could be why Renee never asked or said that there's tension brewing between the two of us, because I already have a rival. Anyways, so on SmackDown, we have a 1-on-1 against Ziggler. The authority goal of winning my match after my opponent does a signature. So that stupid 10 elbow drop thing. Wonderful. Okay, so let's go ahead and get on with SmackDown.
Ziggler is a former World Heavyweight Champion, Intercontinental Champion, a U.S. Heavyweight Champion, and is Mr. Money in the Bank. Ziggler steals the show and everyone's girlfriend.
Yes, that's why he is being booked so well right now on the main roster. Poor guy.
Collar and elbow tie up here.
This is critical for a competitor in establishing themselves in the match.
He's simply reminding him.
So I kind of got part of that here. Down. At least the first time that you whip him, you hold down left bumper, not just press it at the right time.
Oh, after that, you're not seeing stars. You're looking at constellations.
Back off from me and get my stamina back up. Ow. Okay, well, so much for that.
Action like this has become synonymous with SmackDown over the years. This is a level of destruction no one was expecting.
I certainly didn't expect to see this kind
okay,
of damage.
What kind of level of destruction were you looking at? A game of checkers or something?
He's looking to create some separation here.
Yes, because after being groggy, he completely saw that coming.
That hand had a lot of force behind it. Well, he's the guy that's opponent, and what's he going for here? Oh, man, Michael. I remember those rivalries between Ziggler and Mysterio. And let's face it, they're hard to forget. I felt like at any moment, either Dolph or Ray could score a pinfall, and the pace was at the speed of light. Those matches definitely helped put Dolph Ziggler on the map.
Look at this. There is absolutely no wasted motion in this attack.
Going over. See, I think this is part of my problem I have sometimes with this game, is I don't want to waste my reversal and building back up. And that actually about cost me the match against Goldust.
I've ever seen him in.
No, wait, nice reversal.
His astonishing acrobatics coming through here. King, when we talk about Dolph Ziggler against Rey Mysterio, we're talking about two superstars that go about their business in two completely different manners. Ziggler's so enamored about his own ability, and Mysterio, the ultimate underdog, but they have two things in common: to have the best match on the card and to win WWE gold at every opportunity. And his heartless attack continues.
Oh, man.
Yes, his heartless attack by waving my finger in the air.
Not today, too fast.
It's amazing how quickly these guys can get back on their feet when they reverse something.
Gets leveled.
Man, Ziggler's going to be sore tomorrow.
Uh-oh, the back of his head just bounced off the mat with that slam.
You know, Cole, I think you said it perfectly there. Dolph and Ray could not be more different. But when that bell rings and it's about competing in that squared circle, watch out. In their matches for the Intercontinental Championship, both men show that they will do anything
Ow.
To have the best match on the card. He's pulling out all the stops tonight. We might be seeing the beginning of the end.
And Davidson gets all of it.
Ouch, that had to hurt.
Extra slow getting back to his base here.
He sees it. He's showing no signs of letting up.
And there's the definitely give him credit for reversing finishers a little more often. Ow! I forgot he had the super kick as a reversal, or as a signature.
Superstar has the term show-off going across the back of his trunks. Well, or the
look at a catch and the shoulders up.
And the match continues. I love this.
Yeah, I forgot he had the super kick as a signature move.
One of my old drop kicks. Very nice.
It's been a while since I've even seen Lawler do a drop kick. Maybe that's why I said one of his old drop kicks.
Here for SmackDown, as has been the norm over the years.
A superplex.
Yep, that is a superplex.
He's still down after that.
King, Dolph Ziggler prides himself on being one of the most athletically gifted superstars in WWE today. Ziggler is a lifetime subscriber to the ideology, anything you can do, I can do better, and loves when he has a chance to prove it.
I'm not sure if he knows where he is right now.
There, didn't see that drop kick coming, did you?
What a move that was. That was great. How much damage did that do?
A lot, from the looks of it.
Oh, I forgot he had a zigzag stored up.
Uh-oh.
And he didn't do it. He faked me out there.
And his thoughts on, well, himself. And you know what? It's all true.
Dolph Ziggler steps through those ropes every night with the goal of stealing the show and having the best match of the night. And trust me, anyone who is not aware of that, Dolph will gladly bring them up to speed.
We're looking at complete domination here.
Oh, once you get out of the ring, anything can happen. You've got exposed.
And Davidson gets all of it.
Ouch, that had to hurt. I don't know how much longer he's going to be able to go.
There's no coming back from that.
Wow, now that's what you call a finisher. This might be it. Hot damn, it's exciting.
Six. No, or I'm not going to win the match, but I count out.
WWE fans watching this match all around the world.
Say hi to them, all the countries, even Manila, where I use their envelopes.
Manila's not a country.
Look at this. He's just barely moving. I'm not sure he can get back.
I'm just going
to
rest my elbow right here in Ziggler's throat.
Three.
Not a problem with that at all.
Four.
Absorbing a little bit of punishment here. Nothing.
And he's busted open the hard way.
Back in the ring now.
Yeah, let's just see how long they can keep it in the ring.
He needs to dig way down deep if he wants to keep going now.
There. I get back in the ring so I can finish you off.
I can't blame him. Nothing good is going to happen out here on the floor.
Extra slow getting back to his base here.
Three. Four. And he brings the action back inside the ring.
That was a missed boot.
I think this is good strategy.
We know what this is.
Ah, there's the zigzag.
Ziggler uses the zigzag to put this thing away.
What a victory this is going
to
be for
him. Yeah, still got a decent amount of health. The kickout meter should be an okay size.
The shoulders are down.
Now, do me a favor. Stand up.
This one's not over yet. We've seen plenty of people come back from being
Oh, nice reversal into the tornado DDT.
And escaping to the outside.
Go ahead. Climb up top.
To avoid the pinfall.
Oh, he got smart crap. I was expecting him to dive out of the ring on me.
A fever pitch All right. is here in the WWE Universe.
You're right about that. The crowd is buzzing. They're ready for the thing to get
Let's try this again.
Dolph Ziggler is just seething with aggression.
I was going to say, I don't remember
thinking to avoid that.
Having a high cross or a razor's edge as a move. I was going for the pin. I was going to start dropping elbows on me. He doesn't really have any stamina, so. You know what? You're taking a Styles Clash if it kills me.
Some of the pain that's been dished out and find him. His shoulders are down.
One, two, three. What a win. Man, he's got to feel great.
Third time's the charm. I love how they get right back up following something that's not a finisher. Or that's not set to a finisher.
The X-Factor, Russell Davidson.
He gets a victory here tonight. Love him or hate him, that was an incredible match.
An incredible match and a big, big victory. Man, when you get a one-on-one match like that, you hate to see one of them come up short. But that's just the harsh reality of it.
And what a way to end this night of SmackDown action.
All right, so two straight authority goals. That's not something that happens very often.
Welcome back to the show. This is my guest tonight. Let's talk about what happened out there tonight. The rumor is that you're currently injured. Are you at 100% right now?
Does this game not realize there are no injuries in career mode?
That's exactly what it is, a rumor. I fight all day, every day, injured or not. Am I 100%? Yeah, I always am at my best. Does that answer your question?
I also injure people.
Thanks for the time. Back to you.
And if you see half the high-flying moves I do, everyone I've been fighting on this roster would have a broken frickin' neck right now. All right, so that ends August week one. Going into week two, we got a one-on-one with Seth Rollins. I'm just waiting for the time that I go to a match and not even realize it's a title match. But I don't think this game's smart enough to do that outside of pay-per-views. 30 goal, win my match with Redhead Hell. Oh, they're actually giving me a feasible goal in a Seth Rollins match. That's a change. So with that, we'll go ahead and tack on 7 more days to the counter, getting ever so closer to being done with the Intercontinental title. And it's not that I don't like being Intercontinental champion. I'm just ready to move on to new opponents. So with that, I thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time.